Hey, get back! Get off! Get off! Get down!
Stop!
Give your hand out! Mama! Don't move!
How you doing? Rob from Survival Skills 101. Got my buddy Mike here. We're going to go over another situation, self-defense type situation for the street, in which somebody grabs onto you and slams you into a wall, or it could be a car, some kind of object. We've always talked about environment in our other videos. This is kind of where they're using that environment against you. So, right here, I'm faced off, Mike's faced off with me, maybe we're in some kind of an altercation or an argument over something. Could be someone I know, could be someone I don't know. We don't know this right now. It's just a person that's upset with me, and they go to grab onto me and slam me into this wall. A lot of times when people practice this in the martial arts world, they'll already put themselves on the wall, and then the person will grab, go ahead, Mike, and they'll grab or grab the chest or whatever they're gonna grab, and they're already against the wall. That takes away a lot of the real reality of what's gonna happen for more than likely. More than likely, you're gonna be off that object. And when he grabs onto you and throws you, you're going to slam into the wall. And if your arms are like this, you run the risk of nailing your elbow, breaking your elbow. You really should treat this almost like a break fall on the ground. So as he pushes me into the wall, I should be almost break falling on the wall like I would on the floor. Immediately, my hands are gonna come up and they're gonna grab tight underneath his armpits, basically. As far up the back of the arm as I can. If he's got clothing on, I'm gonna grab that. If he doesn't, I'm gonna C-clamp under the triceps if he's got no shirt or clothing on. But if he's got clothing, I am gonna grab as deep as I can. It sounds crazy, but I almost think of grabbing the armpit hair. Because if I grab low by the elbows or even the tricep, I can't keep yourself solid. I can't really move him, I'm only moving his arms. But if I grab closer to the skeleton of his whole body, I can rotate his body very, very effectively, okay? So from here now, I have to next make a decision which way I'm gonna go. And the best way to do that is to look at his feet. Whatever foot is back is gonna tell me which way to go. Because if I try to go this way, he's got a brace there. He's got a kickstand, I can't really go that way. The other direction, there's an empty space over here, an apex, that I can draw right here with my foot. And there's no way he can brace that in time. So if I'm controlling here, and I slide my back down the wall, and I brace myself out, and I lift, and I turn, and I throw him into the wall, now I'm able to take him off balance. And from here, I've opened up all this area to deliver another knee strike. Notice when I turn him, I lift and bend this arm up. If I keep his arm straight and I turn, he's much farther away, and I may not be able to reach with much penetration towards the knee strike. However, as I turn and I lift, his arm becomes a little shorter. And now I can really bury that knee in. It might be one shot, could be two shots, depends on the scenario. Now, when we strike, we're not necessarily striking to punish the person, we're striking so that we can put their body in a position that we can control them. If I tried to take Mike down without striking him from this position, he'd be very difficult to take down. But if I soften him up with a good couple of shots, it automatically brings his posture down into that layer one we've talked about in previous videos. From here, cloning is fantastic. That's why jiu-jitsu players wear gis. Again, I'm gonna grab tight under the armpit, right at the scruff of the back of the neck. I'm gonna step back and I'm gonna pull and push straight down. And from here, his face is gonna go to the ground. I'm gonna lock this arm in. My leg's not out here, it's nice and close. I could technically lock it with just my legs, but I want the security of having this other arm here, and I want to get this palm up where I can see it. Make sure there's nothing dangerous in there. I can adjust how much pressure I put on him with this knee. Right now, there's not a lot of pressure on him. If I rise up, I can really drive that pounds per square inch pressure down on his skeleton. And I will adjust that depending on his resistance level. Okay, come on back up, Mike. So one more time, I'm off here, he pushes me into the wall, I break fall, I grab, I turn off and I lift, I deliver the knee strike. From here, maybe he doesn't have a jacket, I can grab the back of his neck, maybe he's got hair, hair is fantastic to grab. Grab the hair, and I'm gonna pull him down. Right to the ground, and control, give me your hand, let me see that hand, make sure there's nothing else in it, right there. Okay, at any point, once we got the person down here, We have them secured to some degree. Another person could be introduced into this scenario. It might be someone that's helping me. Could be any civilian or potentially law enforcement or something like that coming in to help. And we would, that's fine. However, it could be another bad guy. It could be someone that's with this person that's going to come help them. And we don't want to, we've already fought this guy. We've already got him down to the ground. We're going to be tired. We're going to have the heavy breathing. We're going to have that loss of fine motor skill. We don't need to fight two people now. It's very difficult to fight two people at the same time, almost impossible. So from this scenario, if another person is aggressively approaching me, and I know they're going to help him and not me, I don't want to just get up. And now, he's going to jump up, unharmed, and they're both going to be on me. So if I sense another person coming, it could be from anywhere, 360 degrees. That's why you got to have your head on the swivel looking around. If I see someone else coming, I'm going to rise up with this knee. And I'm going to drop with everything I've got in a knee drop right on that shoulder. And I'm going to break the shoulder. Rise up and drop down. And at that time, I'm going to disengage with him. And my next threat is on me.
Tough guy, huh? Hey, tough guy.
Get down. Get down. Get your stomach. Get your hand. Hand out. Palm up. Don't move.
All right, man.